Hi there and welcome to News 3 at 6. Thanks for sticking around a little late with us tonight. I'm Danica Lewis. The people who live in the small communities of Fairdale and nearby Rochelle where the storm hit hardest say they've never seen something so strong, but they're not talking about the tornado. Leah Lynchide spent the day with them and shares their story of strength.
It happened very, very quickly.
A house that took 30 years to become Doug Fisher's home.
30 seconds later, it was gone.
Torn apart in an instant as he watched from inside.
I heard the noise and the windows exploded and I was behind a little stub wall. I got out of my chair, which was a good thing because where I was sitting, I would have got whacked there.
Today, it's tough to see the aftermath.
Pretty devastating, especially 150-year-old trees all laying on the ground.
And you can see from around here, like, a lot of houses have been destroyed.
All across Doug's Rochelle neighborhood, you can see the damage done. But you can also see what the damage has brought to this community. Dozens of volunteers from across state lines in every direction lend whatever they can here.
We'll have a structural engineer come out here and sort of evaluate some of the...
Like Madison-based American Family Adjusters, who are spending their weekend helping homeowners weave through what's left.
It's a situation where you see on the news all the time, but you don't realize how devastating it is until it comes through your own neighborhood.
Absolutely marvelous. I don't know how I'll thank them.
For Doug, that support is so much stronger than any storm.
It's true. A lot of good friends.
Good friends, neighbors, and even strangers who will help rebuild his home to stand for at least another 30 years.
Oh, yeah, we'll put it back together. Did it the first time. We can do it again.
Tough images to see there. Leah, thank you. Volunteers and insurance adjusters say even though the area impacted by that tornado is small, the community response has been one of the biggest they've ever seen.